amazing.
So I'm just going to pause it. So you're not on camera just yet.
Cool.
Now back on camera, and you're also in drive. So you can see you're in first gear. You're ready to go.
Excellent.
Let's go for it.
All right.
So we're going to take a left-hand turn around here.
Down to left.
That's it. So we just follow this kind of little pit road here, and then we're going to join the main straight on the back here. So apologies for not shutting up now for the next 15 minutes.
All right.
We're all good to go. Okay. So Thank you. second, so down to third, and down to second, so that's on front, and in the front, and in the same position. Get it a little bit, it's all right, we'll get it next time.
Sorry.
That's all right, no worries.
I'm stepping 10 out of 3, mate.
And down to safety, yeah, what we can do is come down to the right area, we can follow the wheel around. Thank you. once you've got your hand stroking it, hasn't it? That lap has been half a second sticking it up.
Oh, it's fantastic. I love it.
Here we Okay, so you're not going to get out anything. We're just going to flip it into neutral for a second. Okay, so first run, 73.76. That's a good time. I reckon we can probably shave about a second off of that.
Okay, cool.
The first thing, we only really got a chance to practice not feeding the wheel on the last couple of laps there.
Yep.
So what, because it's difficult to demonstrate it whilst we're actually going around, but basically, what we were starting off doing, into those real tight corners, you were kind of feeding the wheel in like this, and then as you're exiting, because your hands felt like they were straight, you were getting on the power hard, and the car was steering off to the right. But it's because the wheel was still turned to the right. So what I want you to do is hold on here, and literally at no point on the lap, let go. Always keep the hands exactly here.
So I'm just twisting my hands around top of
me. Even for the tightest corner, just turn your hands around like that.
Okay.
So all that will happen is your arms might touch at the very end, but once you get to that point, you don't need any more lock anyway.
Okay, that's
so
cool.
As long as you're on the right line, as long as you've stayed out wide and then turning, so you've not, you know, you've not made the corner too tight for yourself, that's all you need to do. So you should never ever need to let go at any point. And that'll just make those little twisty corners a bit easier, because you won't find the back end all over the place. It'll just stay settled, because you'll get the wheel, as soon as you finish the corner, you'll naturally just put your hands straight, and then the wheels will go straight, and then you can just go straight forward.
Fantastic,
so
okay.
That's the key thing. Other than that, the only other issues we had is...
Yeah, that corner, I never know quite when to brake it, or...
Yeah, we're, a couple of times we just braked, maybe sometimes a little bit too gently, or other times just about enough, and then we came off the brakes a bit early, that's all. So
I need to be braking a bit hard on that corner.
Yeah, we just need to make sure, the point you come off the brakes, you know you've scrubbed off enough speed to actually make the corner,
that's all.
So luckily everything's so flat here, it's designed for you to go off, but you were getting better and better, and some of the 90 degree corners halfway around the lap, you're really, really good at.
Cool.
That thing with not letting go of the wheel, do that everywhere, because sometimes we were kind of feeding it slightly into even some of the more open corners.
Okay.
And it just basically means sometimes you turn the wheel more than you want it to go, and it induces a bit of understeer. You know, sometimes we ran wide.
Yeah, quite often we ran wide.
Sometimes, obviously a couple of those times because we were just going too quick anyway.
Sure.
But sometimes you can induce a bit of understeer just by turning the wheel a bit too far anyway. So
okay, cool.
As long as you do, as long as you keep it on that, keep your hands there, you'll be fine.
Excellent.
So I'm going to basically shut up this time.
All right.
You drive. If there's anything I think you need to know, I'll try and tell you.
Fantastic.
But other than that, I'm just going to keep dead quiet. Let's see if we can get at least close to a 73 again.
Brilliant.
If not, beat it.
So is this my best time at the moment?
This is your best time here. 70, that's my best time.
That's what I've got to aim for, Brad.
We'll give it a go. Right, we're still on camera.
Yep.
15 minutes. I'm going to just reset this, actually, so we know how long we've been out. And we'll reset it all to zero. Are you happy with where the corners go? Do you know the track now?
I think I know the track, I've got a good feeling for it now, which is cool.
Okay, let's go.
Let's do it.
I'm going to stick it back into drive, so just put your foot on the brake for me.
Yep.
Back into first.
Cool, right. I'm rough.
But you might want to wait for this one guy to come through.
Okay.
As soon as he's gone, we're good.
Turn up him.
Let's do it. Yep, straight out after him.
Cool.
When you got to that last one, so do exactly the same as that again,
yep.
But just brake a bit harder and over for that 90 degree left. Give me a try.
All right.
Thank you.
70.70, and that was a 70.86.
So. Whoa, fantastic.
Good job.
Oh, cheers, that was brilliant.
70 seconds is always good. That's a good lap, especially when we've got some of the cones out, like turn one.
Yeah.
You've got all those cones right across up to the curb.
Yeah.
When they're not there, you can turn in way earlier and cut loads of that corner off.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
So that's a kind of a second there you could gain on a normal day if those cones were there. But they've just laid some fresh curbs, they don't want us driving over.
Okay,
so.
Cool.
Right, now we're going to just swap seats and do a couple of laps.
You're going to show me how it's done, yeah.
But you weren't far off at all. You were only 3 seconds off what I did this morning. So
Wow. That's
not bad at all. We'll get you unplugged from here.
Cheers. That was so much fun.
We're all on camera still. We'll get you strapped in over here.
Work, isn't it?
Yeah, it's funny, you said, can I turn down the heat? The heating definitely wasn't on. We had it on, like, just moderately cool.
Yeah.
But you get really warm in here. The car does get hot anyway.
There's a lot of thinking going on, a lot of... Lovely.
Okay, now down the bottom there, you've got a brake pedal. Just yep. Don't press it.
Don't press it, okay, yeah.
Otherwise
yeah.
It will really confuse me.
Lovely, cheers, bro.
My belt's not hit. So I got a 67.01 I think this morning, so we'll see if we can get close to that.
Yeah, that's how it's done.
As the day goes on and the tyres get a bit too hot.
No, excuses, man.
Can you hear me alright?
Yeah, it got you fine.
They do get a little bit, like at the end of that session there, it was really pushing on, it was really understeering a lot
yeah.
for you, so you do lose a little bit of grip like that.
Cool.
And the brakes are the main thing, they get well overheated, but.
Yeah.
That's my excuse if we go off. Cool, we're all set.
Great.
Well, the brake pedal's gone really long.
Oh, has it?
It's fine, it means you've been braking hard enough.
That's good.
Right, let's go.
Show us how it's done, mate.
Thank you.
Yeah, mate, beautiful.
Let's see if we can get a